myself, Kanto. Today, I'm going to talk about continued proposition. Now, what is continued proposition? Continued proposition means the ratio between first and second is equal to ratio between second and third. Okay, ratio between first and second is equal to ratio between second and third. Then such ratio is called a continued proposition. Okay, I would like to tell you that continued proposition is different from proportion. Okay, proportion means A is to B equals to C is to D. Okay, ratio between A and B is equals to C is to D. Okay, ratio between first and second is equals to ratio between third and fourth. Okay, but in this case, ratio between first and second is equals to second and third. Okay, so there is no fourth. Okay, these two is equal, right? So this is different, this is different. But in this case, all the fours are different. This is different number, this is different number, this is different number, this is different number. Okay, so in a proportion, there is a first term, second term, third term, fourth term. Okay, but in continued proportion, there is a first term, and these two is called a mean proportion. Okay, mean proportion or mean proportion. Mean proportion. Okay, and this is third term. Okay, or third proportion. Third term. There is no fourth proportion in continued proportion. Okay, I hope you understand this. Right, now let's do some example. Right. Find the third proportion. Third proportion of 3:9. Sorry. 3 and 9. Right? Third proportion. Now see, in continued proportion, third there will be a third proportion. Right? So first A. This will be 3 will be A, right? And second is 9. Right, and it says find the third proportion means this one is not given, right? So let's the third proportion be x. Okay, so the ratio, you are going to write this in this form, ratio form. Okay, so 3:9, right? This 2 is mean proportion, so 9:9. Okay, is 2 and this will be x. Third proportion is x. It's not given, so let third proportion be x. So if two ratios are in proportion, then what we know is that product of extreme equals to product of mean, right? So 3:x equals to 9:9, right? So x equals to 9:9/3, right? So 3 ones are 3, 3 3s are 9, right? X equals to 3:9, so 3 9s are 27. Okay, this is the answer. Now try, let's do one more example, right? Find the mean proportion. Okay, mean proportion between 8 and 18. Okay, now mean proportion means this two. Okay, mean proportion means this two. Okay, B, this two will be equal, right? So mean proportion is not given. Solution, let's the mean proportion be x. Okay, so now look at here, A, right? This is A, right? So 8:2, right? Mean proportion means this 2, right? So find the mean proportion, it's not given, so let the mean proportion be x. So x, okay, equals to x. Okay, A is to B equal to B, x equals to x. This is the mean proportion. Okay, is to 18. Okay, first you need to arrange a correct equation. Then only you can find the answer. Okay, so what we know, if the two ratios are equal, then product of extreme equals to product of mean, right? So you can write x into x. Okay, 18 into 8, right? So x into x equals to x square, right? 8 into this one is 8 tens are 80, right? 8 eights are 64. That means 144, right? So put square root on both sides, okay? Put square root on both sides. Okay, so square root will be cancelled. What is left here? X, right? And square root of 144 is 12 into 12, right? That means 12, this one. So square root cancel. What's the value of x? 12. Okay, and this is how you are supposed to find the mean proportion and third proportion in continued proportion. I hope you enjoy this lesson, and thank you very much for watching this video. Thank you.